Hello students, how are you all? Hope you are good and doing great. Welcome to English class. I am Sarita and today we are going to start a new lesson, The Great Stone Face, Part 1. The lesson is written by Nathaniel Hawthorne. So, Nathaniel Hawthorne is the writer of this lesson. This lesson, The Great Stone Face, revolves around an old prophecy, which says that, the old prophecy says that a man would be born in the valley who will resemble the great stone face. Now, what is great stone face? Great stone face is the artwork of nature. When these rocks are piled upon each other, they resemble a human face. So, the rocks are piled up in such a way that they resemble a human face. That's why this rock is this kind of rock is called as the great stone face. Now, according to the old prophecy, a man would be born in the valley who will resemble this great stone face, means who will be bearing the likeness of the great stone face. So, great stone face is nothing but the artwork of nature, and it is formed by the rocks, and when it is looked at from a particular distance, it appears like a human face. So, this kinds of rocks which are appearing like a human face, this is called as the great stone face. And according to the old prophecy, a man would be born who will resemble this great stone face. So, the whole chapter revolves around this old prophecy. So, let us start the lesson now. Let us start the word meanings first. Perpendicular, rising very steeply. Immense, huge, big. Spectator, onlooker. Those who can see, those who are watching something. Enormous, very big. Prophecy, statement that tells what will happen in future. So, this lesson is based on an old prophecy. So, prophecy means a statement that tells what will happen in future. तो prophecy का मतलब है कोई भी ऐसी भविष्यवाणी कर देना किसी के भी द्वारा जो कि future में होगी, जिसे हम भविष्यवाणी कहते हैं English में. Affectionate, loving and caring. Pensive, thoughtful. Thoughtful means a kind of person who thinks very much. So, this is pensive. Let us see the characters of the story first. Characters, Ernest, it is the name of a boy. Ernest's mother. Then, Gathergold, name of a person. Then, Blood and Thunder, it is the another name of a person. So, these Blood and Thunder, Gathergold, Ernest, mother. ये इस स्टोरी के कैरेक्टर्स हैं. गैदरगोल्ड एक व्यक्ति का नाम है और ब्लड एंड थंडर भी एक कैरेक्टर का नाम है, व्यक्ति का नाम है, पर्सनालिटी का नाम है. ओके, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट द लेसन. सो इन दिस लेसन देयर वाज अ वैली इन विच द रॉक्स आर पाइल्ड अप इन सच अ वे दैट दे आर रिजेम्बलिंग अ ह्यूमन फेस. So, that rock is called as the great stone face. And in the lesson, one fine day, Ernest and his mother were sitting outside their house and they were continuously gazing at the great stone face. Now, Ernest's mother told Ernest that according to the old prophecy, a man would be born in the valley bearing the likeness of the great stone face. Now, Ernest, who was very affectionate and pensive kind of child, he kept thinking about the old prophecy and he kept looking towards the great stone face. So, he never forgot about it and he expressed his desire to his mother that would he be living when the great stone face resembling man would be born, his mother told him and consoled him that he may live. So the mother just consoled him, saying that yes, he would be there when the great stone face resembling man would come in the well. So after that, Ernest always kept thinking and always kept looking towards the great stone face. It was like his habit. It has become his habit to look at the great stone face. So every evening he used to sit for hours and he used to gaze towards the great stone face. Now he was, when he was in his own moods, he was a pensive kind of child. One day a word was spread across the valley that a person named Gathergold was coming to the valley. He was the native of the same valley, and long back he left the valley to become a successful business person. So the same person is returning to his valley to spend his last days in the valley. So when Gathergold came to the valley, it was believed that Gathergold is the same person bearing the likeness of the great stone face, which is according to the old prophecy, Gathergold was the same person, and he was having so much of wealth that it would have taken 100 years to count his wealth. So now it was believed by the people that Gathergold is the same person who has the likeness of the great stone face. मतलब जो लोग थे वैली के, उन्होंने ये बिलीव कर लिया कि जो Gathergold है वो सक्सेसफुल है, वो वेल्दी है, और इसलिए वो ग्रेट स्टोन फेस से भी रिजेंबल करेगा, क्योंकि जो ओल्ड प्रोफेसी थी उसके अकॉर्डिंग ऐसा व्यक्ति होगा जो कि नॉबलिस्ट होगा. तो जो वैली के लोग थे उन्होंने Gathergold को ही वो नॉबलिस्ट पर्सन मान लिया. सो दे बिलीव्ड दैट, एंड सडनली ही स्टार्टेड लूजिंग हिज वेल्थ, एंड आफ्टर हिज डेथ इट वॉज seen that people stopped believing in Gathergold because he lost everything during his last days. Now people thought that they were wrong in believing Gathergold as the same noblest person according to the old prophecy. So now they stopped believing in Gathergold after his death and after he lost his all wealth. Now Ernest again became curious that, and he kept thinking that someday a man would come. So now he slowly he was growing up, and he was a very helpful and kind child. He was very affectionate child, and his habit was still the same. He used to look at the great stone face in the evenings, and all the people of the valley, they like Ernest, but this one thing bothered them, that he used to sit for hours and gaze at the valley. Only this thing they didn't like about him, but still other thing about Ernest were good. So they believed him as a good child. So slowly Ernest was growing up, keeping in his mind about the old prophecy. Slowly he was growing up, and gradually in a period of time this stone face has become the teacher for Ernest, and by looking at him, and it was appearing as if the stone face was having a kind and gentle expression, which is inspiring Ernest also to be very kind, affectionate and gentle, as he was having a smiling face. So Ernest ko ab laga ki jo ye great stone face hai uske liye teacher ki tarah hai, aur wo usse regularly kuch सीख रहा है, जैसे कि जो उसका स्माइलिंग फेस था उससे उसको पॉजिटिव थिंकिंग मिलती थी और उसकी जो काइंडनेस उसके फेस में झलकती थी, दैट ऑल्सो वॉज इन्फ्लुएंसिंग अर्नेस्ट अ लॉट. तो उस चीज से अर्नेस्ट इन्फ्लुएंस हो रहा था. तो स्लोली जो वैली के लोग थे वो अर्नेस्ट को लाइक करने लगे, क्योंकि वो एक हेल्पफुल चाइल्ड था, लविंग चाइल्ड था, केयरिंग था और बहुत ही काइंड और जेंटल पर्सनैलिटी के तरह ही वॉज बिकमिंग. नाउ सडनली वन फाइन डे अ वर्ड स्प्रेड अक्रॉस द वैली दैट अ मैन हुज नेम वॉज ब्लड एंड थंडर was the native of the valley and he has risen up to the rank of commander by his hard fighting, through his hard fighting, and he is known as the blood and thunder inside the army. तो उसने बहुत सारी ऐसी courageous fights की थी blood and thunder ने, इसी वजह से उसका नाम blood and thunder रख दिया गया. thunder मतलब तूफान, blood मतलब खून, तो मतलब खून खराबे वाला तूफान जैसा पर्सनैलिटी. तो जो वो व्यक्ति था ब्लड एंड थंडर, ही वॉज कमिंग बैक टू द वैली. नाउ अगेन द पीपल ऑफ वैली स्टार्टेड बिलीविंग दैट ब्लड एंड थंडर वुड बी द सेम मैन, बिकॉज ही वॉज करेजियस इनफ, ही वॉज वेरी ब्रेव एंड ही हैज गॉन फॉर हार्ड फाइटिंग्स इन द आर्मी. तो उसने जिस तरह से उसकी जो पर्सनैलिटी थी वो सबके सामने आई, लोगों ने बिलीव कर लिया कि जो ब्लड एंड थंडर है वही ओल्ड प्रोफेसी वाला पर्सनैलिटी होगा. सो दे स्टार्टेड बिलीविंग इन ब्लड एंड थंडर एंड प्रिपरेशंस आल्सो वर हैपनिंग इनसाइड द वैली टू वेलकम ब्लड एंड थंडर. एंड द पीपल हु वर नॉट एट ऑल लुकिंग एट द ग्रेट स्टोन फेस, they started spending hours and they were looking at the great stone face in order to see the resemblance between blood and thunder and this great stone face. And when the day arrived, blood and thunder also arrived on one day and people were gathering to see him and they were shouting in joy that and they were saying that he is the same man according to the old prophecy, he is the same man, he is resembling the great stone face. But Ernest was very curious and he wanted to see blood and thunder and he also wanted to compare the faces of great stone face and blood and thunder. Wo blood and thunder ke aur great stone face के जो फेसेस थे उनको कंपेयर भी करना चाहता था. सो एवरीवन वाज कन्विंस्ड दैट ब्लड एंड थंडर वाज द सेम मैन, बट अर्नेस्ट व्हेन ही सॉ ब्लड एंड थंडर एंड ग्रेट स्टोन फेस बिसाइड हिम, ही कुड नॉट बिलीव दैट बिकॉज देर वाज नो रिजेम्बलेंस बिटवीन ब्लड एंड थंडर एंड द ग्रेट स्टोन फेस. सो नाउ Ernest got disappointed, but his heart said that Ernest, one day that man would come, and he was consoling himself. So in Great Stone Face Part 1, this was the story. This was all about this lesson. Let's have a small recap of the lesson. Let's have word meanings first. So perpendicular, rising very steeply, immense, huge, spectator, onlooker, enormous, very big, prophecy, statement that tells what will happen in future, this lesson revolves around this old prophecy which is there in the lesson. Affectionate, loving and caring, Ernest was very affectionate. Pensive, thoughtful, Ernest was also a thoughtful person, a thoughtful child. And then characters of the story, Ernest, his mother, gather gold, blood and thunder. So these are the characters of the story. And in the beginning of the lesson, Ernest and his mother were sitting outside their house and they were continuously gazing at the great stone face. And then Ernest's mother told him that According to the old prophecy, a man would be born bearing the likeness of the great stone face. And after that, Ernest became very curious. He wanted to know when the man would be born. And then he started looking continuously towards the great stone face. Gradually, after some time, this great stone face has become the teacher for Ernest. And he was developing those qualities of kindness which he was getting, which he was influenced by this great stone face. Then suddenly Gather Gold arrived. He has become very wealthy, as he have left the valley long back, and now when he was returning to the valley, he has become wealthy. He was so much wealthy that it would have taken 100 years to count his wealth. 100 साल लगते उसकी जो धन दौलत थी उसको काउंट करने में, इतना ज्यादा वैली था वो। तो जो लोग थे वैली के, उन्होंने बिलीव करना शुरू कर दिया कि जो गैदर गोल्ड है वही वो व्यक्ति है जो कि जिसको कि ग्रेट स्टोन फेस की रिजेम्बलेंस है जिसके फेस में, और यही वो व्यक्ति है क्योंकि वो काफी रिच और वेल्दी है और उसने काफी स्ट्रगल किया है। पहले वो एक शॉपकीपर था, ही हैड बीन अ शॉपकीपर एंड नाउ ही हैज बिकम a wealthy person. So they started believing that Gather Gold was the same person. But Ernest was not satisfied because he was not seeing any resemblance between the great stone face and Gather Gold. And when Gather Gold died, he lost all his wealth and he lost his influence on the people of Valley. Now the people of Valley again started believing that the man would be coming after some time, because Gather Gold was not the same person. And then Ernest gradually, he was growing up and he was developing those all qualities of kindness, and he was very affectionate, he was very helpful child. So the people of Valley were liking him for these kinds of his qualities. So, and he used to look at that was his regular habit, he used to look at Great Stone Face always. Then Blood and Thunder arrived in the valley, and the people of Valley welcomed him with great pomp and show, and they were believing, they were shouting and saying that Blood and Thunder was the same person because he has risen up to the rank of commander, and he has gone through a lot of fights. He had hard fightings during his training and during his army service. So they started believing in Blood and Thunder that he is the same man. But when Ernest saw him, he could not find any resemblance between Great Stone Face and Blood and Thunder. So he believed that soon a man would be born. His heart said that don't worry Ernest, your man will come. So this was all about the lesson. This was the story. Hope you have understood lesson. And if you have any doubts, you can call me or you can message me, children. And take care of yourself. Thanks for joining me. Bye-bye.